Hey everybody, I'm Lance Koike, and today we are talking about the bent over one dumbbell row. Now, if you've watched my last 329 videos, you know that I don't have any weights here in my apartment here. So we're gonna use this empty gain bottle as our dumbbell. Basically, I'm bending over, and then I take one hand and I row it up. Only one hand has the weight. Let me switch sides so you can see the shoulder motion. I gotta make sure that the shoulder comes back first and then the elbow follows. What it looks like when you do it wrong, either you turn a lot, you shift your weight with the row and you use your hips to do it, or you don't get the shoulder motion and you just bring your elbow up like this. Lots of times it probably looks more like this, okay? So if I do that, I'm not getting the upper back muscles that this exercise is really designed for. And so then it's like, why am I even doing it, right? If I'm driving with the hip, I'm not loading the upper body. What I would prefer you to approach this exercise as is a lower body exercise with upper body movements, okay? So I want you to keep the lower body square, like you're standing on railroad tracks, or like your car with its wheels directly on the road. The road is not turning, you need to be straight forward. And then as I row, your weight is gonna start to shift, or it's gonna try to shift. And if I let my hip turn, then I don't have to row my shoulder up quite as far. But I'm doing a row, I'm trying to load my shoulder. So I want to keep my hips square where they're at and learn how to dissociate my upper body from my lower body. Just like that. And when I really get that, I can, even with this gain bottle, I can feel a little bit of turning on in my upper back muscles in those, the trapezius and the rhomboids that we talked about earlier, previously. So that is a great rowing variation. You don't need hardly any space. You can just stand there. You only need one dumbbell or a gain bottle. I could literally fill this with water and it would be a weight that I could use at home without having to spend a lot of money and still being able to give myself some exercise. Cool. Watch. Let me do some from here. Watch the shifting, because this is where things are going to mess up, right? Looks okay right now, but if I do even just like this, so I let it go there. I hope you can see that. I'm gonna move this hand. Let's square up again. This looks a little better. And then I'm gonna let it go a little bit. Okay, just that little bit was enough. And I'm gonna let it go a lot of bit. And yeah, some people do row this way. So these are things I want you to be able to watch out for, okay? Make sure your hips stay square. Make sure the pressure on your feet stays, you know, flat over the entire foot. I don't want your feet rolling from side to side or shifting from toe to heel or heel to toe or anything like that. Cool. This is the bent over one dumbbell row.